day.
People talk real about talk, it. I ain't throwing shots. All of the elements. Hello, everybody. Dr. Rick Wallace here, dropping in on you. I hope that everybody is winding down their week and preparing to have a positive, prosperous, and enjoyable weekend, however that looks for you. Look, I'm going to spend a little time with you here sharing something that is immensely passionate and important to me and my wife. For those of you who have followed me for any stretch of time, you know I'm passionate about proper preparation and the socialization, especially racial socialization of young black males. That's what Black Men Lead is all about. It is about the proper preparation of black males. What I want to really hit home here now are just some simple things we need to understand. If we're truly talking about the empowerment of the black race, if we are truly talking about the liberation of the black race, if we're talking about actionables, if we're talking about strategies, if we're talking about true engagement, then we have to understand the importance of preparing the black man to move in his true manhood and masculinity. We have so many orifices and cracks and crevices in the structure and infrastructure of our culture that are a direct result of failing in the proper preparation of our black men. First of all, you have to understand that if there are no black men to protect, to provide, to cover, to lead, to be the frontline defense for our beautiful women, our children, and our elderly, we have no true hope of ever truly rising to a level of what we can consider to be genuine and authentic empowerment. With that being said, just some of the things that I think about when I'm working with young black men as a part of what we do at Black Men Lead, and that is a black male who drops out of high school is at a 70% increased risk of becoming incarcerated before age 30. Additionally, the risk of being murdered are committing murder is increased exponentially by something as simple as dropping out of high school and not being engaged by some other alternative method of preparation, education, and empowerment. And this is all coming from a school system, an educational system that's designed to alienate the black male starting at age 5. So we have to be keenly cognizant of our youth being at risk. Now, with Black Men Lead, we work on socialization because we know when we properly socialize our males, they are less likely to commit violence. One of the things that I have given thousands of hours of research and program development to is addressing the issue of African American adolescent and young adult male violence. I've done that over and over and over again. And will continue to do so. What I want to talk to you today is about a specific component of what we do at Black Men Lead, and that is specialized intervention. What specialized intervention is, there's the program. There is the rite to passage program, which is an embodiment of Black Men Lead. But there's also an understanding that we have young black males who are individuals, who have individual struggles, individual challenges, who are at risk for incarceration, who are at risk from dropping out and becoming violent or being victims of violence and victimizing our young girls in intimate partner relationships. And it's our responsibility to directly intervene and engage that and do what we can. And so I offer specialized interventions, meaning that a person comes to me, predominantly mothers come to me and they say, hey, this is my son and this is what's going on. And for so long, I've done that, and I've done that without fail. But I made an announcement at the end of last year that I could no longer take on programs without the proper support. Haven't gotten a lot of support since then, but some programs I was able to keep going, some are not. These personalized, specialized interventions are something we really truly need. I right now have three mothers on deck who need specialized intervention for their son. This is intensive therapy, for those who don't understand what I'm talking about. This is intensive therapy that is approached from an Afrocentric perspective and understanding the Afrocentric male dynamic in African-American black males. So this is something intense, it's something necessary, and it requires time, energy, effort, program development, and all of the nuances that goes along with diagnosing and understanding and identifying the issues, confronting the issues, dealing with the issues. And it is an expensive process. It simply is. I can devote as much time as I can, but I have to provide and feed my family. So I have to work in my businesses. What I'm looking for now are people who are willing to sponsor these young men, either donate towards a sponsorship. But what I'm doing is I'm asking, these normally cost for a 12-week intervention, cost about $2,500. I'm asking people to sponsor these young men, and I've got more on deck, but these are three immediate needs. I'm willing to do more than half. If we get $1,000 sponsorships, I'll cover the rest, but we need that. We need it badly. Description box is going to be a link that you can go to and you can give. If you want to sponsor an individual wholly and solely on your own, it's greatly appreciated. If you want to give $5 towards a sponsorship, it's greatly appreciated. But what I want to do is I want to be able to reach these men, and these men will be sitting down directly with me. These aren't simple programs that they're going to participate in. This is a personalized, specialized intervention, and we desperately need this type of support. We can't continue to lose our young black men to the system, to the pulls of a nefarious culture. It's our responsibility to stand up and say we're going to do something about it. I've been doing this for years. I want to continue to do this, but I need your support. That's where I'm going to leave it at. You can either sponsor, you can sit up and say, hey, I want to sponsor one individual, and you can do that. That's $1,000. I'm going to cover the other $1,500 by basically absorbing that cost. But what I need is I need you guys' support. If you want to say, I just want this to go towards, and you donate $5, your $5 will be appreciated with the same level of gratitude as someone who gives a lot more. I know everybody has a lot going on, and I will not marginalize your sacrifices, but I will tell you that we do need your help. On another note, if you are a parent with a child at risk, please reach out to us. The email to reach me directly will be in the description box as well. There's work to be done. On that note, I'm out of here.
Hello everybody, Dr. Rick Wallace here, dropping in with a little special announcement. For those who have followed me for any stretch of time, you know, outside of the businesses that I run, like Myriad Business Solutions, the Visionetics Institute, Odyssey Media Group, I also do a great deal of work inside of the inner city communities in Houston, Dallas, and other areas. I'm asking now, as we push a fundraiser, that you support what the Odyssey Project is doing in the inner cities, especially with programs like Black Men Lead, which is a rite of passage initiative, and Restoring Ghettos Forgotten Daughters, which is a program focused on helping young girls, but boys as well, suffering from childhood sexual abuse, rape, molestation, domestic abuse, absentee fatherhood, and so many other things. The information will be in the box. Thank you.
Conceptual perspective, people talk about it, sound of success, all of the elements.